who's gonna harden it here for the time to come? Who's gonna help the so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, and Seminole Indians of indigenous descent in America? If you're waiting for the so-called European to do it, they're not. They're a bloodline of thieves, liars, and devils and deceivers.
Right.
And all nations that had their hand in our captivity has to pay for what they've done to the unindemnified people, man.
That's right.
All right, read on.
Who will give Jacob for a spoil and Israel to the robbers?
Who gave Jacob to the spoil? And who gave Israel to the robbers? If you understand anything about biblical history, the kingdoms were divided into the northern and southern kingdom. And so the kingdoms were split. All right, so you had the northern tribes and the southern tribes. You had the northern tribes scattered, and then you had the southern tribes who were initially in Judah, as Judah, Benjamin, Judah, and Levi. Those were the southern tribes. So this is talking about the children of Israel. This is not talking about all nations. Read on.
He against whom? Selachim. Did not the Lord? He against whom we have sinned?
So who did all this to us? Ultimately, the Heavenly Father has put us in his present condition. Because of what? Read on.
Now, for they will not walk in his way.
Because we didn't walk in his way. Right. So we were the only people on Mount Sinai when Moses gave the law to. We did not listen to him. And the Heavenly Father has put us in this condition. So when you don't return back to the Heavenly Fathers, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, and Seminole Indians, you will never be indemnified.
That's right.
You will never get justice. You will never get peace in America. If they're not doing it by now, isn't it funny how the technology has progressed,
right?
But our condition is still the same as to when we were brought over.
Con.
Something is wrong with that picture. You got satellites that can see what's in my mouth, that can count my teeth and the ones that are missing.
Right.
But you can't indemnify the people that you know you had in captivity and treated them like garbage with all the contributions that we've made. With you would not have nothing. This would be a dry place. Your entertainment would disappear overnight.
That's right.
You'd be crashing into each other because the traffic light was invented by a so-called Negro.
That's right.
It would be no civilization if it wasn't for my people.
That's our contribution.
We're the ones that civilized the carcass dweller, the cave dweller.
Right.
They came out of the caves eating out of skulls.
That's
you
right.
got Europeans that admit to this fact, that it was melanated people that educated them. Even the history of ancient Asia, or the place that's called Asia Minor, the original samurais were Negroes.
Right.
The Buddhists were Negroes. Every culture on the planet Earth, they got their identity from us.
Bring it up.
Bring it up.
But how did we fall so far?
But they were not walking his way. Neither were they obedient unto his law.
So our people weren't obedient, man. Give me Deuteronomy 28 and 15. So this is what happened to us, and this is why we're in this condition. And so my message is only to our people. It's not to the dregs and the downtrodden, the ignorant, and those that are to be judged. You look at that picture, and you believe you've been deceived too, Mr. White Boy. You've been deceived. You know why? Because you think this is Jesus.
No, I'm not.
Jesus doesn't look like this.
That's right.
That's right.
This man right here has been what has been portrayed as a criminal act that the so-called European has been getting away with for years.
But his time is up.
This right here is Caesar Borgia, the illegitimate son of Pope Alexander VI of Rome. He actually lived.
That's right.
He was a man that lived. He had sex with his own sister. All right? He was a effeminate homosexual. All you gotta do is study. You can tell that you're ignorant because you don't know this truth. This is your history that you need to be aware of.
That's right.
This man was a devil. He was a living devil, and that's why we got horns on him. And it's not the description of how he looked according to the Bible.
That's right.
All right? So we're gonna bring that out, but you've been duped and deceived and believing that this is the Messiah, which is a damn lie, according to the Bible. Give me Revelation 1 and then we'll jump to 13. Read what you got. Deuteronomy 28 and 15.
Book of Deuteronomy. chapter 28, verse 15.
Bring it out.
I thought America was founded on Judeo-Christian principles. That's what Ronald Reagan said. The damn devil and a hypocrite. Ain't nothing about America established on the Bible. Gay and lesbian rights, that ain't in the Bible.
That's right.
What are you talking about? This is a hypocritical nation, and the Heavenly Father will destroy it just like he did Sodom and Gomorrah.
That's right. That's right.
But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of Yahweh thy power.
This would happen to our people, because we would not listen to him and have righteous judgment. Righteous ruling needs to go in the earth. And then our people will stop mourning. And y'all will be better off when we're in power.
That's right.
All right.
To observe, to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So the Most High brought these curses on us. And our people got to get out the mindset that all we can do is name it and claim it, that Christian garbage. You will never be free from the one that put you in this condition until you return to him.
That's right.
You'll never be free. It don't matter how much you come out here and teach and preach and stand on these corners. If you're not keeping laws, statutes, and commandments, you're fighting against the Most High, man. You fighting against your salvation. You fighting against your deliverance. If you're going to continue to defile your body with a cigarette, if our people would continue to break the laws and not wear a beard and have a manly mane like the Most High required for us in the scriptures,
right.
If we don't hearken to him, we're going to continually be destroyed by his hand.
That's right.
Yeah, the white man is the devil that the Bible speaks of.
That's right.
And he's the instrument of cruelty that the Most High is using. But if you want ease from this devil, you gotta submit to the Most High, resist the devil, and he will flee. We resist the Heavenly Father by keeping these laws, man. Go back and 2:8-15 again.
But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of Yahweh thy power, to observe to do all his commandments and the statutes which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. Curses.